We're going to take a look at a way we can present our pictures. We're going to go from this to this. We're going to be using layers, adjustment layers, layer styles, and text. Right, let's make a start. Let's go over to this tab. Now here is our image. It is showing it as a background layer. Now we need to duplicate this background layer twice. So I'm going to use Command J, Control J once. We're going to use Command J, Control J again. Now you'll notice we have got layer 1, which was the first copy. We have now got layer 1 copy, which gets a little bit complicated. So I like to rename our layers. That way you can instantly look at your layer stack. It doesn't matter how many layers you've got. It could just be one, it could be many, and you'll instantly know what you've got on this layer. Now to rename it, bring your cursor over the text. If you double click, that has now highlighted it, and I'm going to give it a very imaginative name. I'm going to call this particular one Image. With our image layer, we're going to reduce it in size. We're going to go to Image, Transform, Free Transform, but we're not going to use the grab handles. Instead, under Tool Options, make sure Constrained Proportions is ticked. I'm going to swipe across and we're going to enter a figure. Let's take it to 80%. And as we look around, you can see it's just a little bit too much of a framework. I've still got my cursor here. So on a Mac, I'm going to use Delete. On a PC, use Backspace. That has now removed it. Let's try a figure of 87. That looks pretty good like that. Can just see a little bit of a hand, handbag, rug. Yeah, that looks good. Dropping that down out of the way, we can now click inside the frame. Click on the green tick to apply it, and there it is, job done. Right, let's switch off the visibility of this layer, and we can do that by clicking on the eye icon. We now need to make layer 1 the live layer, so we're going to click on this. This is now our live layer, and as we've done before, bringing my cursor over the text, double clicking, we're going to call this blur, which is a bit of a clue. We're going to blur it by going to filter. We're going to go to blur. We're going to go to Gaussian blur. Now this will depend on the file size that you're using. The file size, the document size I'm using is 28.2 megabytes in size. We've got the radius here of 19.4. So it's this sort of squinty look that you want, but don't worry, it is going to be adjustable as well. So I'm going to click on OK. Right, next, I'd like to brighten up this layer. Now this is our top live layer, so if we come up to this half black, half white icon, when I click on this, when we go down to levels, because we're going to use levels to brighten it up, that'll put in the adjustment layer above that live layer, so in it goes. With levels, if we move it across to the left hand side, we introduce more of the lighter pixels. So I'm going to go to the center slider, we're going to move it across. And there it is, hey presto, the image brightening up nicely, taking it into that area, going to click on the little cross in the top left hand corner, and there it is. Right, let's switch back on the visibility of our image layer. Let's click on our image layer to make it our live layer, and we're now going to put in a drop shadow around this. Now for the drop shadow, we're going to be using a layer style, which we'll find under the effects icon. So clicking on this, notice the way the layers have now gone. We've now got our styles, filters, effects. Make sure you click on the center one, styles. Make sure from the drop down menu, you select drop shadow. I'm going to use this one here, which is high. And if you double click on it, there it is. Let's click back on layers, which is going to bring back our layers panels. You'll notice a little FX icon. This is indicating a layer style has been applied. I know you can't see it, it's off the recording area, but that's what it'll tell you. And if you double click on the effects, now look what happens, you get your style settings. Bring your cursor out. You may remember when I started off, I had the hand tool. It has now become the move tool. This will allow us to move the drop shadow around. And I'm going to take it over into this sort of area here. You can increase the amount of drop shadow by taking the size out like this. Just want to bring it over that area a little bit on the top, but I want to sort of match in the lighting. We've got shadow around this part here. That looks pretty good. We're going to click on OK. No, I'm not. I'm going to leave it for a moment because for the next stage, I want to apply a stroke border. Now it's very tempting to use a stroke here, or you could do it from the effects tab as well. But I'll show you the reason why I don't like this method. If I put a tick in the box, size 3 pixels, color black, doesn't matter. If I just take it up into this area here, look at that. It's around the outside of the image. We got this curved look. And if you look at this curved look, it's a very jaggedy look. I don't like the way this works. So I'm going to switch that off. We're going to click OK, which don't forget is for the drop shadow. But now to apply the stroke border, if we go to Edit, we're going to go down to Stroke Outline Selection. Now when this opens, there's our stroke. The width, you may need to experiment again. This will depend on the document dimensions that you've got, but 14 pixels should be okay for this. Color, black, no, don't like that. Clicking in the window, we'll bring up our color picker. I'm going to select, all right, dull and boring. We're going to go for white. Location. This is the important thing. Make sure you have got location set to inside. Click on OK. There it is. We have now got a nice sharp stroke border going right the way around the image. Next, how about a bit of text? We're going to come over to the toolbox. I'm going to pick up the text or the type tool. Now with the text or the type tool, bring it into the image. I'm going to click down, and as I click down, look what happens. A new layer goes in. It's called layer one. It's called our text or type tool. It's called layer one for the moment, but don't worry, that'll change in just a second. If we go to the tool options, you can see there's the font I'm using. If you click on this downward facing arrow, there it is. You've got all these fonts available to you. I've chosen this one because I just like the sample. I thought it would work with the text that I'm going to apply. The largest size we've got, if we go to the drop down menu, is 72 points. Yes, I know you can't see it. It's off the recording area, but if I click on 72, you can see there it is. The color, click in the window here to set your color, and I'm going to go, once again, being predictable and boring, I'm going to go for white. Right, now that we've got all of this, I'm going to pop that down out of the way. We're going to give Toby his full name, which is Tobias. Now, at the moment, this is not what they call committed. In fact, if I just pull my cursor over there, it says commit your current operation. In other words, commit your text. Remember I said about the text layer being called layer one. Well, if you click on the green tick to commit it, or if you just double click over this area here, we've now committed it. Layer one now takes up the name, or whatever you've put in there will take it up on this layer. It's now saying Tobias. Bringing my cursor out, we've got that move tool. We can move it around. We can reposition it on this layer. You can put it anywhere here that you want to. I'm going to put it down in this area here, but I'd like to make it a little bit bigger. Now to make it bigger, I'm going to bring my cursor over this T thumbnail. I'm going to double click on this T thumbnail, which has now highlighted the text. I'm going to press and hold down Command or Control. And as I press and hold down Command or Control, we've now got the transform tool around this. I'm going to pull it out on one of the corners. We're going to make it larger by taking it up to that area there. That looks pretty good. So I'm going to click on the green tick. We can now reposition it. Something like this. But how about giving this just a little bit more definition? We're going to use a drop shadow, but rather than coming back down to the effects icon, we're going to come up to our image layer where it says effects here. I'm going to press and hold down the Alt or the Option key. So I'm holding down Alt or Option, going to click on the little effects icon. As I click on and lift it up, look at this, we've now got a double arrow with effects. You can see very, very faint, bringing it up onto this layer. Watch what happens when I release it. We've now got a drop shadow. Remember, if you bring your cursor over that little effects icon, if you double click, brings up the style settings. There they are. These are the settings that we used for that original drop shadow. So what I'm now going to do is I'm going to drop the size down. And as I take the size down, look at the way that drop shadow is becoming a little bit harder. Like the way it is there, bringing my cursor out with the move tool. I'm going to reposition it something in that area. That would be pretty good. We're going to click on OK. Now to finish off, I want to put a stroke line around the outside. The reason for doing that is if you've got any light areas in your picture, it's easy for the eye to wander out, so I just want to hold it in with a very subtle stroke line. For this, we're going to come up to Select. We're going to go to All. So we've now put a selection around this layer here. But if we put in a new empty layer by clicking on this icon, Create a New Layer, what's happened is that selection has come up onto this new empty layer. where it says layer one, we're going to double click. We're going to call this what it is, which is going to be a stroke. Right, now with the stroke, we're going to go back to edit. We're going to come down to stroke outline, and there it is there, selection. So there's our selection. If we click on this, there's the dialog box we had before. I'm not going to go for 14. I'm going to drop this down. Let's go for, I don't know, 8 or 9. Let's go for 9. Rather than going for white, which will just be a little bit of a conflict with that one, we're going to go for something in the 50% grey, just perhaps making it that area there. It looks pretty good. We're going to click on OK, making sure, again, it says inside. Clicking on OK. There it is. Believe it or not, it really is there. Let's go to select. Let's go to deselect, Command D or Control D. There is our stroke border. Let's use Command 0 or Control 0 to go to fit on screen. If I bring my cursor into the workspace, if I right click, I'm going to go to a black background. Now you can see that stroke border. Now something with this, let's just take a quick look because everything here is completely adjustable. You can change, if I just double click, you can come into your tool options, you can change the font, you can change whatever you want to do with the text. I'm not, so I'm going to leave that as it is. As we've seen, we can edit the drop shadow. Now with the layers here, with the adjustment layer, this is looking through. Remember we blurred this. If I click on this layer, so our blur is now our live layer, the opacity is set to 100%. What if I'd like to see this blur just a little bit clearer if I reduce the opacity down? That was the reason for duplicating the background layer and blurring it, because it gives me the option to be able to reduce it down and perhaps view it like that. What about this layer here, this adjustment layer? This adjustment layer is now using its brightness. It's going right the way through the blur layer to our background layer. In fact, if I switch this off, look at this, and you can see there it is brightening up nicely. If I switch that on there, you can see the way that brightens up, so it's going through here. If I switch the background layer off, look at the way we got this checkerboard background indicating that this layer has got a reduced opacity. Let's switch this back on. Something else you might like to try. This is the live layer. We're going to put in another adjustment layer. So back up to the half black, half white icon. Let's go to hue saturation. Now with hue saturation, let's take the saturation down to that area. There, you might even want to take it out and have black and white entirely up to you. I'm just going to remove a little bit of the saturation, something like this, and there it is. So go on, give it a try. It's a great way of presenting your pictures. Save it in layers, save it as a .psd file. That way everything is completely adjustable. We can come in, we can make any changes to this. And I always recommend putting your pictures aside, leaving it for a couple of days, then look at it with fresh eyes, and you might want to change things, you might want to adjust things, but go on, give it a go. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Please like and subscribe, that way you'll get new videos as they're being released. But until the next time, it is happy imaging, and take care.